don't want to take any more of their time, but would you welcome Paul's Journey to Dale City?
Praise the Lord. Amen. Well, look, I'm just sitting back there, just, isn't it good just to sing about Jesus? Amen. Well, I'll tell you what, especially that last song, I love that song. Amen. What a lovely name, just the name of Jesus. Thank you.
Y'all having a good time at the Lord's house today?
Amen.
Amen. I'm glad to be here. We always enjoy being here at this place. Thank you for being here. It's always a great time. You know, there was a time in all of our lives when we needed a Savior, right?
Amen.
Amen. We all came to that point. If you're a Christian, you came to that point in your life where you realized you needed that Savior. You met Him face to face. Maybe even there's someone here tonight that hasn't had that encounter tonight, today. You need to meet that Savior today. And we're glad to be able to proclaim Him to you and lift up His name and let you know that there is a Savior waiting for every need. So Gary's going to come sing this great song. It's one of our favorite songs on our latest recording. That's simply what it says. I needed a Savior. You can see. Christians, something we should do is be a blessing to others, right? And this church, Pastor Beard, this church, man, y'all are great at that. Going out feeding the homeless and having all these things. And that's great. So we were thinking about that, and we took an old hymn, and we put a Paul's Journey twist on it. All right, and we'll see what that sounds like. Let's try it here this morning, guys. Make me a blessing.
She had been going through a lot of health problems. In fact, she'd been having a lot of seizures. And they were fixing to go in the hospital. In fact, she was going in that next Tuesday to have a serious brain surgery and to try to correct these seizures. And it came time for the altar call, and we gave an invitation, and there was lots of folks that came down to the altars that day. And the pastor was praying with them, and I was out here, and she came out, and she came to me because she knew me. And this is what her request was. This was her prayer to God, okay? She says she's fixing to go to the hospital on Tuesday. Now, she didn't go up there, and a lot of people, we do this, of course, and it's all right to do this, but she didn't come in asking God to heal her before she even went into the surgery. She didn't ask that God would guide the surgeon's hands while they're doing this very serious brain surgery. That was not her request. You know what her request was? She said, God, may I be a blessing to someone while I'm in that hospital. Amen. That should be the desire of every Christian. To be a blessing to someone else. Amen. So maybe even this week, make a commitment. Strive to do that. Be a blessing to somebody else. And boy, I tell you what, God will bless you a whole lot more for it. I guarantee you will. Amen. I'm going to tell y'all this morning, I need a blessing. Well, when you're a singer or a preacher or whatever you might be, and your voice starts going out, man, my voice just kind of went out up there a while ago. I know what happened, and it's coming back now. The greater is He's in me than He's in the world, right? Yeah. But I never know what's going to happen up here in Oklahoma City. I'm telling you, it beats anything I ever. We came up here one time and an earthquake happened. Come up here this time and the voice goes out. I never know what's going to happen here. I know one thing's going to happen. We're going to have church. Amen? Praise the Lord. Hey, we're going to do this one song, then we're going to turn it back over to the pastor, and then we're going to come back and finish up. And I like this song. We sang it last night. And I'll make a stand on this, and I want us, my Christian brothers and sisters, to make a stand. If you're tired of what's going on in this world and in this church and in your life, and if you're tired of the devil pushing you around, listen, it's time to stick up for what God wants you to do, and that is stick to His word. Amen? This little song says, that's God's story, and I'm sticking to it. There we go.
Here we go now.
Whoa, that's your story, and I'm sticking to it.
make a blessing for them today. And if you have a love offering, we're going to just take up a love offering and give. Fine. If not, God knows. So, gentlemen, will you come forward and we'll keep on letting them sing. But they've been a blessing and we're going to hear a sermon and everything. So, I like to be a blessing to these groups. You know, they come and last night Bedlam took some people away. So, we are privileged to have them stay over. So, Lord, bless this offering and those that can give and those that can't. Continue to bless Paul's journey in my name. Amen.
Pretty good about there, huh? That's Keith's first time to sing that one with us. We hadn't even rehearsed it. He looked at me and said, "We hadn't even sang this one yet." We did all right, huh? I like those old songs like that. We're going to do another old one here. If you were here last night, the other group did it, but we're going to do it again because it means a lot to me. Last year, my grandmother and grandfather both got cancer, and she ended up passing away. And he's still battling with it. He's going through radiation again right now. And they were very, very close to me. They were the ones that were there for me, even growing up. My parents got divorced and a lot of things. And so they were the ones I would go to. So that was really hard on me because I didn't have them to turn to during that time. And what it did, it forced me to put my focus more back on God, right? As a Christian, that's what we should do. We should go to God first with our problem. But sometimes we get in situations and we call grandma, you know, which that's fine. I mean, they're spiritual people. But it forced me to get my focus more back on God, and also reassured me once again that He'll be there with you no matter what you're going through. Amen. So if you're facing something this morning, whether maybe it is cancer, death of a loved one, so many different things we can face, I encourage you to just reach up and hold His hand, and He'll help you walk through that valley. You listen.
And the He calls me son when I
Because he sent his son. There's some scriptures in the Bible here, and if y'all can pull that up on the screen, look at 1 John 4:19. He says we love him because he first loved us, right?
Yeah.
We're going to go back here. I think it's 1 John 4:10. Look at this. In this is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his son to be the propitiation for our sins. And that word right there, propitiation, that means that he made a connection between us right there, right? And that connection was Jesus Christ. Jesus became that sacrifice that we needed to get to God. Isn't that cool? I like that. Go to that next scripture. Look at this one. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believed in him should not perish but have everlasting life. There, see, he just proved it again. He just didn't do it for me. He just didn't do it for you. He did it for the world. He desired that relationship for this whole world. And there's still a whole world out there that needs to hear that. I think there's one more I want you to see, because it falls in with what we just said, song right there. He has that relationship with you now, okay? The Bible tells us that when we became a child of God, he wrote our name in the book of life. So he knows each one of us personally now, right? Jeremiah 29:12-13 says that when you call upon me and go and pray to me, I will listen to you. And you will seek me and find me when you search for me with all of your heart. Folks, I want to tell you something. We did this while at the beginning, people came to this altar. When you come to an altar of God, and you call upon your Father, he not only will listen to you, but he knows your name.
He knows you today. So what this does is it opens up an opportunity for you. Maybe you have a special need, and today, the day you want to present it to the Lord today. And I beg you to do that today. Will he meet that need for you directly on this altar? I don't know that. I can't answer that. But I can tell you this. I can promise you this. Whatever your need might be, no matter how big, no matter how small, but whatever your need might be, if you are willing to come and make that commitment and by faith kneel at an altar and turn that over to Him, I can guarantee you that when you get up, you will walk out of here better than we came in, because you know that my God has my back. And then if you're in this place today, maybe you're visiting, or maybe you've been coming, but listen, you've never made that commitment in your life. You've never asked Jesus in your heart. My question would be, does He know your name? Has your name been written in that book of life? Because if not, it could be. Today. Today can be the greatest day of your life right here. This could be the start right here. I can't do it. Pastor can't do it. It has to be your decision. It has to be a personal decision. But again, I urge you, if that's you tonight, if that's you today, don't walk out of here lost. Don't walk out of here unsaved today. Amen. Open your heart. Let the Holy Spirit, who is in this place right now, let the Holy Spirit draw you to your Father. He has a desire to have a personal relationship with you. Will you stand with us today? We're going to have a hymn of invitation, of time of altar. And I'm going to ask you, those of you who need to, look, step out even once more. Maybe you already came, but maybe step out again and come to this altar of prayer today. Call out His name. I will listen to you. Whatever your need is today, take care of it. Right now, as they sing, God speaks to your heart. If you need special prayer, we'll pray with you. I guarantee you we will. Whatever it is, you come right now. Come on.
All to Jesus I surrender. All to Him I freely give. I will His presence take me. I surrender all. I surrender all to Thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender.
Sing this chorus with us.
These folks, I love this pastor, and so many faces that I've seen down through the years. We just love you so much, and thank you for letting us be a part of this. We do have some CDs over there. Everything you hear us sing, we've got it on CD. We'd love you to take some of those home with you. We'd love you to pay for it. But if you can't, look, you hook me up. I guarantee you, I want you to have some good music in your home. We've got the little, it's personal bracelets over there. We've got the t-shirts. Listen, again, great witness wear. If you're tired of the old devil pushing everybody around, then show it. That people say, look, I'm sticking up for the gospel. And then we've got the other one. Stand tall. Stand as a Christian today, and no matter what. Keeping on. All right, we've got those over there. Y'all come help us out on that. That's part of our ministry as well. We appreciate you so much.